Hi, and welcome to Tommy's Trade Secrets. This short clip is all about carpentry and how to do it right. Hopefully you'll find it useful. Take a look at the step-by-step guide, and if you like it, print it, keep it, and use it.
Hi, I'm Andy from TradeSupermarket.com, and today I'm going to show you how to fit Architrave to a door frame exactly like this one. Tools and materials needed for this job are Architrave, set square, hammer, tape measure, pencil, some oval nails, centre punch, sandpaper, mitre box, some wood glue, or alternatively some grip fill, a tenon saw, or alternatively you can use a jigsaw, and please remember your safety glasses. Right, the Architrave we're going to use today is this particular one, which is a pre-primed MDF Architrave. And the best thing to do is get your set square, set it at 6mm, and then what you want to do is have it set 6mm from the inside edge of the frame back. So what we do is we get our set square, we mark some lines on the timber, just put a few lines all the way down, like so, and then just mark your head as well, and this will link in the head architrave to the upright architrave. Right, as you can see, we've marked our door all the way around at 6mm. Then the next procedure is to get our architrave, place it on our lines that we made earlier, and then what we do is just pencil a line on the architrave, and that is the angle we're going to take to set our first mitre in. Okay, what I'm going to do today is we're going to use our mitre block, and the best thing to do is just try and secure this to the surface that you're working off with just a couple of screws at both ends of the mitre block, and this prevents the mitre block from moving, and obviously you've got two hands to cut your mitre on your architrave. Right, now we're ready to cut our mitre on our architrave. We've already marked that from the door frame. So what we do is we place our architrave in the mitre block. We get our tenon saw. Use our left hand, push firmly onto the architrave, get our tenon saw and make our cut. Best thing to do when you're using a tenon saw, just let the tenon saw do the work itself. Just push it nice and gently through and you'll find it a lot easier to cut. Now that piece has been cut off, so remove our tenon saw. As you can see, we've now got our 45 degree angle that we need. Right, we're now ready to fit our architrave. So what we do is turn the architrave over, we get our wood glue, we run this on the back edge of the architrave, like so. We turn our architrave over, we place it on our lines, always making sure that we've got the two lines meeting at the head, like so. Now there's so many different ways you can fit architrave. You can either screw it and then fill it afterwards. What I'm going to do today, like I said, is use these oval nails, and instead of putting it on the raised areas, what we're trying to do is we'll put it in a recessed area so it's a lot easier to fill. So what we do, get our hammer, and as soon as we get down to the surface of the architrave, we then get our centre punch, place this on the oval nail, we hit the nail in, and as you can see, I've only got a little bit of filling to there to do today. Right, next step is get another oval nail, place it in the centre. And if you just take this to the surface, we can like put the rest of our oval nails in all the way down of our architrave. Once we're happy with the position, then obviously we can then place a centre punch on the oval nail and then drive the nail into the wood. So we continue this, like I say, all the way down holding our architrave, then fixing, and again, bring it onto our line, fix again. Right, now we've fitted our last nail, what we do, we'll grab our centre punch, place it on the nail, drive it home, and do this all the way down the architrave. Right, now our architrave is fixed in position. What I do with the head is show the other option that we mentioned today, and that is with the jigsaw. Right, now we get our head of the architrave, and I know that we're going to create a 45 degree mitre from top to bottom, running off this mitre here. So what I'll do is I'll just mark that, so I'm not wasting too much wood. I'll turn the wood over and just mark the backside, because when we do our cut with our jigsaw, instead of doing it on the front face where we haven't got a flat surface, we do it on the backside of the architrave. Right, the next procedure is to get our set square. We just adjust it a tiny bit. We place it on the backside of our line. Hold it in place, mark a pencil line across. Now this is obviously the mitre that we're going to cut, which will link into our upright on the right hand side. So next job is put your safety glasses on. Always wear safety glasses when you're using electrical equipment. Then we get our jigsaw and make sure that it's firmly in place. Hold the jigsaw on our line. Run the jigsaw across, and because we're using a power tool, it'll leave tiny burrs of timber. So what we do is we get our sandpaper and we just rub these burrs off, and then we have a nice clean mitre. Right, now we have our mitre cut, what we do is we place it on our line, and then that links into our mitre that we made earlier. Then obviously the other side, we have our line. We can then mark our architrave, and then we know that the next mitre is going to start from the top and work its way out. Okay, now we have our mitres cut at both ends. What we do is we place our architrave on our head just to make sure that we're happy with the angles. And we get our wood glue and run our wood glue on the back edge of the architrave. Then also just run a line on where the mitres are going to be joined together. What we do, we place this on our head. This can be a little bit fiddly because you've got the glue on the back side. It might slip a little tiny bit, but if you hold it securely in position, you'll find that it'll be okay. What we do is we hold it in position. We get one of our nails, and drive it in to the surface of the timber. What we do, grab another nail, place it on the timber, tap it into the timber, make sure the architrave is still on the line, put our nail in to the surface of our architrave. What we do, we put four nails in this head today. And then finally, the last one. Again, we get our centre punch, place this on our nail, and then drive this home. And what you do is just continue this procedure on the head, and then obviously when we fit our upright on the left-hand side, you continue the same procedure all the way around. Right, now, as you can see, we've got our architrave fitted, and what we want to do, we had a little bit of filler left over, so what we've done is just knock some up in a little pot. And just to hide the pin heads, what we do is just wipe a little bit on your finger, place it in the groove, get yourself a little damp cloth, anything to do, a little dish cloth, and just wipe that through, like so. once that filler's gone off, you can then get your sandpaper, just square edge it, fold it over. You can place this in the groove, just wipe that up and down, and that'll bring that back nice and flat. And then you're ready for undercoating and then top coating with your paint. Right, that's another job completed today. Remember, all your tools and materials can be purchased through tradesupermarket.com. Thanks very much for watching today. So stay tuned for more of Tommy's Trade Secrets.
I hope you found that useful. Now click below to find all the tools and materials you need for the job. There are products from loads of merchants, all at the cheapest prices on the web. Thanks very much for watching Tommy's Trade Secrets. Oh, would you mind rating this video and spread the word?